Will AI be the downfall of humanity? This video was generated entirely by AI. And so was this one. And this one. And this one too, for good measure. All of these videos were produced by OpenAI's new tool called Sora, which launched a few weeks ago. It's currently in closed testing, but they did some reveals. OpenAI is, of course, the company behind ChatGPT, which went viral a year or two ago for its insane capabilities. I now want to show you what AI-generated videos looked like 1 year ago, and I'm totally stealing this from Marques Brownlee, who's a way bigger and way better YouTuber than I am. Here you go. The prompt for this video is Will Smith eating spaghetti. Now compare that video to the ones you saw that were made by Sora. That's how far AI-generated videos have come in 1 year. Add that to the increasing amount of AI art, AI-written essays, and just general increased use of AI by the public, and you'd be totally in the right if you were feeling a little concerned. I know I am, especially when I remember that this technology is only going to get better as time goes on. I originally wasn't going to make this video right now. I had it saved for a bit later this year, but the release of Sora has changed everything. So this all begs the question, is AI coming for us? Are we doomed? How will society be impacted by this technology? Will we as countries and as individuals be able to keep up with it? I'm gonna do my best to answer all of that right now. Without further ado, let's get into it. You might think AI became relevant just a few years ago, but that's actually not the case. The concept of artificial intelligence, as many people know it, consists of a machine writing essays for them, producing images of cowboy dogs riding horses, and other things like that. But the reality is that artificial intelligence boils down to one simple question. Can machines think? Of course, the answer we now know is obviously yes. But back in the 1970s and even before that, scientists weren't so sure. Throughout that time period, numerous advancements were made though. Machine learning was an early advancement in AI, as systems began using algorithms to mimic decisions made by quote-unquote expert decision makers. But that's not necessarily important now. I'm only bringing this up so you know that AI has been around for a while, and it's in everything. Your calculator is AI. Marketing chatbots are AI. Facial recognition is AI. Every company uses AI in some way or another today, just not in the way we may typically think about it. The public perception of AI was skewed with the launch of ChatGPT in November 2022. And to be fair, the product is incredible. You can use it to write thank you notes, love letters, essays about World War II, which I've already mentioned multiple times, and so much more. That last example in particular wreaked chaos on education systems around the world. With the launch of this tool, teachers and professors had no idea whether an essay a student had written was legitimate or not. As a former college student and graduate of Stick University, I know numerous people who used this to write essays for classes and they 100% got away with it. I won't say who though because I'm not a snitch. While tools were created to better detect AI written essays and other things like that, there is zero doubt in my mind that ChatGPT changed education forever. And that's far from the only sectors of life it's impacting. You want to be a writer when you grow up? An artist? An animator? A drone pilot? A photographer? Something else I can't think of in this list? Look out, the robots are coming for you. That's a dumb question for me to ask because AI is already coming for our jobs. This technology is only going to get better over time, meaning more and more companies are going to start using AI to cut corners and not pay workers. If you don't believe me, look at the news. AI is causing students to rethink their creative career plans. AI is already taking video game illustrators' jobs in China. Workers are worried about AI taking their jobs. Artists say it's already happening. And for those of you who aren't in a creative industry and think you're exempt from something like this, AI is starting to threaten white-collar jobs. Few industries are immune. All of those articles are linked down in the description if you're interested in giving them a read. I'd highly recommend it. Basically, the overall takeaway here is that AI is coming for many, many jobs. Some people have already lost their jobs due to AI. Some have had to put in extra effort to keep their jobs. Others have had to fight extra hard to come to terms with their bosses surrounding the use of AI in their industry. I'm looking at you, Hollywood writers. The point is, the onset and evolution of this technology is extremely concerning, especially when you consider how AI has already come for many working class jobs. We've got robots in factories now, we've got self-checkout at grocery stores, and much, much more. I want to end this section with info from the analyst firm Forrester, which put out a 2023 report on AI and its impact on the job market. The report concluded that generative AI will replace 2.4 million jobs in 2030 while influencing another 11 million. The report also had a section titled, quote, "Let's be clear, generative AI is coming after white-collar jobs." Basically, this really sucks, and we're all in trouble. Once you stop looking at the tech on its surface as really interesting and something we've never seen before, the problems it brings with it become very hard to ignore. AI is already having an impact on the job market right now, and it's going to have an even bigger impact in the future. Younger generations are going to have to think long and hard about what job spaces they want to enter. Who knows where we'll be 15 to 20 years from now? It's very possible that we'll see entire sectors swallowed up by AI. Outside of that, though, how else will AI impact us? How else might it impact you? Is society at large in danger? I don't know for sure, but I'm going to try and answer. Let me start this section with a little hypothetical scenario, since that's what this channel is all about. We're in an election year. It's 2024, and all signs are pointing to a rematch between Joe Biden and Donald Trump for the presidency. With as messy of a news cycle as this is, things get a whole lot messier when a fake AI video of Joe Biden goes viral, where it appears that he's going to try and steal the 2024 election. This might seem ridiculous to you, but in reality, it's not too far away. We've already seen how AI can fake videos of people in a realistic way, but can it replicate voices? The answer is, without a doubt, yes. In fact, it's already happened. Earlier this year, during the New Hampshire Democratic primaries, voters across the state received phone calls from Joe Biden telling them to not vote in the primary and to save their vote for the general election. The only issue? Joe Biden never said such a thing. Take a listen.
We know the value of voting Democratic when our votes count. It's important that you save your vote for the November election. We'll need your help in electing Democrats up and down the ticket. Voting this Tuesday only enables the Republicans in their quest to elect Donald Trump again. Your vote makes a difference in November, not this Tuesday.
I want you to pretend that you didn't know that voice was fake for a second. Would you have been able to differentiate it from the real Joe Biden if you weren't paying super close attention? If something like that audio were distributed alongside some sort of fake AI-generated video like we saw earlier, how would you be able to tell it apart from the real thing if you weren't actively looking for fake stuff? On a broader scale, these questions represent my main issue with AI. How will we know what's real and what's fake anymore? Considering, again, that this is the worst this tech will ever be, how do we ensure it isn't used maliciously? We've already seen people share fake AI-generated images to go viral, and the reason that happens is because certain groups of people, mainly older people, share things without realizing they're fake. And it's not their fault, nor are they the only group of people to fall for such things. This technology is insane, and it's only going to get better and better. If you do not spend much time analyzing things before sharing them, it is absolutely possible that you could share something that is AI-generated and totally fake. You are not immune to this by any means, and neither am I. If you want an example of how something like this can cause chaos, look no further than a completely fabricated France 24 TV broadcast that circulated on a Russian Telegram. The anchor in the broadcast claimed that French President Emmanuel Macron wanted to visit Ukraine, but backed out due to fears of an assassination attempt. So many people fell for this, including former Russian President Dmitry Medvedev, who released a statement on X about the whole thing. The issue is, the broadcast was completely fake. Clearly, AI has political implications. There's no doubt about that. But it can also be used to inflict personal harm. Take Taylor Swift, for example. The pop superstar recently had fake, AI-generated explicit images of herself circulating on social media, as they evaded safeguards and went viral as a result. One image recorded over 45 million views. She's now considering legal action against the creators of the images as well as the software that they used. There are plenty of other women out there who have been negatively impacted by this technology. I've linked an article in the description that dives deeper into the issue. I would highly recommend reading it because some of the stuff it discusses is not suitable for YouTube, but it's a problem that definitely needs more attention. Even if you still think this doesn't affect you personally, it may one day. This is a totally exaggerated example, but imagine a scenario in the future when you're arrested for a crime that you didn't commit and then shown a fake video of you committing that crime. What do you do in that scenario? This stuff has all kinds of implications in everyday society on top of how much harm it's already done. But enough about that. Let's now try to find some solutions. How do we put a stop to AI, or limit it enough so that it won't do as much damage in the future? We needed laws to regulate AI like a few years ago. When it comes to the exploitation of women and AI-generated explicit imagery, something is being done. But in the political world and on social media at large, AI-generated imagery, audio, and video is running rampant. It's seriously the Wild West on there. Simply put, we need laws on this kind of stuff. And to be fair, politicians are working on them, just not fast enough in my opinion. After the Taylor Swift issue, politicians began to speak out more on the issue of explicit deepfakes. But things have been in the works before then. Last year, in an attempt to make deepfake porn illegal, New York Congressman Joseph Morrell introduced the Preventing Deepfakes of Intimate Images Act. This bill was referred to the House Committee on the Judiciary on May 5th, 2023, but nothing has happened with it since. Outside of that, we've got to get laws into circulation that prevent the use of AI-generated audio and video for malicious purposes or personal gain. I have absolutely no idea what these may look like because I am not a lawyer, but there has to be a way to prevent the spread of fake content that may be used to influence people in one way or another. And like I said, to be fair, things are in the works. More than 30 AI-focused bills have been introduced in this Congress. House and Senate committees held nearly 36 hearings on AI in 2023 alone. We're making progress, but so is the AI. So we need to do more about it before it's too little too late. Short answer, no, not yet. Longer answer, who knows? Our lives may one day be dominated by this kind of AI. In fact, it kind of already is. AI tech is revolutionary. It's nothing we've ever seen before. The advancements of Sora, ChatGPT, Midjourney, and other artificial generation platforms are mesmerizing, yet at the same time, terrifying. Time will tell whether we were able to clamp down on these types of platforms or not. I just hope it isn't already too late. That's all I've got for this hypothetical. If you enjoyed it, please feel free to like and subscribe. I really appreciate you watching. Like all of my other videos, I researched this one all by myself. I may have left something out or accidentally made a mistake, and if that's the case, I apologize. If you're interested in learning more, all of my research links are in the description. And one more thing, this video was not made by a robot. I am a real human. See you next time.